huge Thermomix. Welcome to Kieran Zerner. Well, hello, hello. It is so wonderful to be here. Thank you, Bianca. Thank you, Grace. How do we connect better in our teams for better results? Okay, as we talk about this concept of connection, you know, how do we amplify that? How do we amplify that into our conversations? How do we amplify that into our culture? And ultimately, how do we amplify that through our customers and our community? To do that, we need a little dose of curiosity, which is why I'm also going to invite you today, and you'll see it on your desk, on your table. There's bubbles. This is all about having fun this morning. So today, what does a scientist do? What does a scientist do? Thank you, we've got some bubbles already. What does a scientist do? They ask questions, exactly. What else does a scientist do? They experiment, exactly. And they observe. It's a lens that we get to see through. Because in this room, look around. Just look around at all these beautiful faces. Just have a look. This is where we're going to solve some of the challenges that you have today. And so we're all going to take up the challenge to experiment. There'll be lots of chance to try some things. I'm going to make you role play. I'm going to make you do skits. No, I'm just kidding. That's terrible. I'm definitely not going to make you role play. Definitely not going to make you do that. So we're going to start off with some curiosity to begin. We're going to split into some. $7.8 trillion. There was a Gallup survey in 2022. That's just a guesstimate at the world's lost productivity. So if you were to put a value on lost productivity, that's the cost. That's about 11% of the global domestic return of income. So if you're sitting there thinking, oh crap, I've lost a lot of sales. Oh crap, my team's a bit disengaged. Then you're not alone. I think that's the first thing. Leaders are needed now more than ever. Leaders to refresh, to regenerate, to rejuvenate workplaces. Just to tap into this energy and bring that back to your teams, that's the start of it. In the last 20 years, I've been working in comms and working with corporate leaders and working with small businesses. The thing that I've noticed is some teams are fantastic. Some leaders are amazing. I think to myself, is it just that there's natural-born communicators and the rest of us give up? No. I think there's something that we can learn. There's structures we can put in place that can help all of us